Alright guys, this is my impressions of Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. It's an indie adventure game, and it was developed by Starbreeze, who you might know, who did the first Darkness game, and it was published by 505 Games. It's a pretty interesting game, for sure. I kind of waited for a long while to get it, and that's for various reasons, and those kind of tie in with the problems with the game, which I want to go over, and it might be a factor to some people. But overall, once I got it and I was playing through it, and I really like it. It's pretty cool. It's different, and it looks really nice. It's got a really cool world, and it tells its story not in the usual way that most games do, and how I personally am used to it. So I wasn't sure about that either at first, I'll admit. Anyway, I want to go over the problems really quick, which there isn't that many. The first one is cost versus length, and a lot of people have addressed this, which it is. I got it on Steam sale, which is why I was willing to get it. I got it for only $3. The game normally without sale goes for $15, and I have to say, I kind of can see why a lot of people have a problem with that, because it really does not last a long time at all. The game only lasts for a few hours. Now, those few hours are really good. You get to see some really cool scenery. Visually, it's really cool. It's got some really nice music. The gameplay is really nice. And the story is told through the gameplay, which is what I'm going to come back to when I'm done with the problems. But it is an issue paying that much money for something that really does not last that long, and people have brought the same argument up with things like Flower and that Journey game on the PlayStation Network, but they say that even though what the cost is and how short it is, the time is definitely worth it. And I can see that with this one, but even at the same time, I'd say think about it and be cautious about it, because $15 is a lot of money to spend on something that only lasts for a few hours, you know? So that is kind of an issue I see with this, and would probably be a factor in deciding whether to get it or not. That's one that was kind of causing me problems to get it or not. And the other one, which usually is something that kind of really puts me off of a game, but didn't with this one for various reasons, which I'll come back to, is it really is an easy game. There pretty much is no challenge at all. There is a lack of or hardly any challenge to the game. It's not very hard at all. It's very simple. It's pretty easy to figure out all the puzzles, and it's not complicated at all. It's a very linear game. There's only very small alcoves and little places you can go to explore, which usually most of the time are just for getting achievements, which there's only 12 of them. Other than that, there really isn't much else to do. And that's part of the other thing to it, is it's not a very challenging game, so it's not like it warrants replaying for any kind of challenge factor, you know what I mean? So that's kind of an issue too. Other than those problems, everything else is really nice. Visually, it's a very cool looking game, both graphically and also the aesthetic with the visuals and the scenery. Really cool looking. This has got to be one of the coolest looking worlds I've seen in a game in a long time. And one of the things that adds to that is this game doesn't tell the story in a traditional way that most other games do, for dialogue and things like that, little notes you can read in the game like a lot do. This one, pretty much, and one of the cool things about it, and the reasons why I like it, and makes it kind of unique, is this game's story is told through the gameplay. Now, one of the other, and pretty much the most unique thing about it, is you're controlling two of these brothers, the younger one and the older one, with one controller. It's a single-player only game, it's not co-op. You control both characters at the same time. Basically, you have dual controls. You use one stick for one brother, one for the other one, and use the left trigger and right trigger for the other one. This game was meant to be played with a controller, by the way, and I gotta say, it really was. I tried playing with a keyboard, I figured it out, but it just was not good. They really say, when they say in this that it was meant to be played with a controller, they weren't kidding. It really does work better that way, and to be honest, if you didn't play it with a controller, you're kind of missing out on the full experience, really. So there's that. But it's very unique, and I didn't really expect to like that for it, because it doesn't tell story for the traditional way that I'm used to for all these years, playing RPGs and all other kinds of games, and I wasn't really sure about that. And as I was playing through it, it didn't take really long to get used to it, really. It was bizarre at first, I'll admit, and I couldn't really get them to go in the same direction at the same time, because I'm not used to it, you know what I mean? But after a while, I got the hang of it, and I was able to get so good at it where I could actually literally do different things with both characters, and you're going to see that in the video I have going here. But you know, it's a pretty unique thing, and it's different, and I can't really think of any other game I've ever played myself where I get to control two characters at the same time and I could do different things with them. And that also ties in with the actual puzzles themselves and gameplay, where you have different things you have to do, and one brother has to do one, and the other one has to do the other one. And certain things can only be done by one brother or the other, as you just saw there. Only the smaller, shorter, lighter one can go up top and pull the thing down so the older brother can get across. There's a lot of stuff like that in the game, and most of the puzzles pretty much involve that kind of thing. You also come across many different characters. There's a scientist. There's all different kinds of things. I'm trying not to ruin the story much, which is the hardest thing to do with this game. You come across all different kinds of creatures and different characters, but again, they don't talk, really. They talk, but not in any kind of decipherable language. It's not in English or anything like that. Again, it's, like I said, the story is told through the gameplay and what you see. And you see some pretty amazing stuff in this game. I'm not going to lie. It really is. I don't want to ruin it, so I can't explain any of it, unfortunately. But let's just say some of the stuff you see in this is pretty cool and surprising and not what you'd expect, really. And some of the things you have to do for the puzzles, too. I will say a little bit about the story, though. It's not really ruining it. It's what you see in the beginning. The whole thing is you play as these two brothers, and you have to help their father. He was very ill from some kind of he's stricken with some kind of illness. And you go on this adventure and quest to find this giant magical willow tree, which for some reason has this healing liquid at the top of it. And you have to bring that back to your father to cure him before he's dead. And you see that they lost their mother long ago, and now you're trying to save your father. And it goes from there, and you go across all different kinds of places across the world, different environments. At one point, you go to basically an ice tundra, all different kinds of things. I gotta say, this area here you're seeing is probably my favorite, the mines. I just think it's really cool looking. And for that, like I said, you come across different characters, you do many different things. It's got some of the coolest looking scenery I've ever seen. And every level of one of these areas, you come across benches where you can sit there. And I did a few in this video so you can see what I meant. And you get this really cool scenery you can look at. I like it. It's something different. You know, it's not what I expected from it. Now, I don't really have much else to say overall, because there really isn't much there to talk about. Do I recommend this game? Yes, but with the things I mentioned, you have to keep in mind that it's very short, there is pretty much no challenge to it, and the cost. I do recommend pretty much getting this game when it's on sale, because it's a safe bet then, like $5 maybe, or below. I mean, if you're willing to spend more, okay, go ahead. But I'm just saying, the cost versus how long it lasts is an issue for many, many people. It was for me. I gotta be honest with that, and this is kind of what kept me from getting it for the longest time. But it definitely is really good. Is it the best game ever made? No, I don't think so, because like it doesn't have pretty much any challenge, and to me, a game should have that. It's not very long, but that's okay. Not every game is supposed to be 80 hours long like some RPGs. That's fine. As far as the length goes, by the way, I'm fine with it. For what the game is in itself, it's the length it needs to be. I do wish it was a little bit longer, because it is one of those cases where you feel like, I wish there was a little bit more, and that's the kind of thing I had with this game, because I had a lot of fun playing with it. You know what, I'm going to play through it again. I play through all my games multiple times, just the way I do it, so I'll definitely get my money's worth out of it, even though I got it on Steam sale. But, you know, it is an interesting game, it is a very good looking game, and it's fun, and it's something different. And I gotta say, one of my top favorite things about it, other than the scenery in this game, is how they handled the story. Seriously, I like it. It's not the only game I've ever played like that where it tells the story primarily through the gameplay. But this one, I think, fits it perfectly for what they were going for and what they did. And the story isn't all happy-go-lucky, by the way. That's as far as I'll go with that. I don't want to say any more. But it does make you think, it does make you wonder, and it does try to evoke something in you. And a lot of people say they got very emotional from this game. I didn't, me personally, but I've already explained in the past through response videos and other things that games don't do that to me, but I can see why. You know, it is a pretty powerful stuff, some of the stuff you see in this, and I didn't find it really pretentious, me personally, or heavy-handed, and I like that for it, and I appreciate it. It's a very good game, very well made, and it's fun, and it's definitely worth playing, I'll say, sale or otherwise. It's worth getting. It's a really cool game, I like it a lot, and they did a very good job on it. It's pretty cool, and the world itself is really interesting, and I like how you're left to figure out things about it yourself. So that's really all I have to say about it. Brothers, Tale of Two Sons, I do recommend it with the things I said in mind. So that's it. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you next time.